Well, you have there, Rose.
It's my Christmas list. I've been a very good girl this year, and I'm gonna get lots and lots of cool Christmas gifts.
Hey, I'm writing my Christmas list too. Although I got sent to the principal's office last month, so I didn't make mine very long.
Oh, really? Is that how you think it works?
Well, yeah.
Guys, that's not why you get gifts at Christmas.
Then how?
It's fun to get gifts at Christmas, isn't it?
It's the best. Last year, I got the iPad I wanted. This year, I was amazing. I scored 5 goals in soccer, and I already made the honor roll. This year, I'm thinking Disney World.
Rose, you may have been the best soccer player, but that's not why you get gifts at Christmas.
It isn't?
No. Haven't you heard the saying that Jesus is the reason for the season?
Hey, I've seen that sign up at church in the lobby.
Right, the whole story behind that saying is the birth of Jesus.
But what does that have to do about getting gifts?
Christmas isn't about getting gifts, it's about the gift, Jesus.
Oh, you mean Jesus dying on the cross for our sins?
That's a big part of the story, but that's the second part. For the first part, you'll have to go about 30 years before that.
But you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the leaders of Judah, for out of you shall come forth the ruler, who will shepherd my people Israel.
Greetings, fair everyone. The Lord is with you. Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you shall conceive in your womb and have a son, and name him Jesus. And he will be great, and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will have no end.
How can this be, since I'm a virgin?
The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. And for that reason, the Holy Child will be called the Son of God. For nothing is impossible with God.
May it be done to me according to your word.
Mary decided to trust the angel God sent to her, even though it meant life would get very hard for Mary and her future husband, Joseph.
Thank you.
The angel also appeared to Joseph.
Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child that has been conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. For he shall save his people from their sins.
I will do as the Lord commands.
Joseph decided to trust the angel and do as he was told.
All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophets in the Old Testament.
Behold, the virgin will bear a child and shall have a son and shall call his name Emmanuel.
But what does Emmanuel mean?
It means God with us. It was a big deal for Jesus to come and live on our earth with us. It was a big deal for him to be born as a baby and live on our very own earth. What a big deal it was when Jesus was born. When Jesus was born, they wanted to celebrate. They wanted to share the good news with everyone.
In the same area where Jesus was born, there were some shepherds staying out in the field and keeping watch over the flock of sheep in the night.
They were minding their own business when suddenly an angel appeared and started talking to them.
Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy, which shall be for all the people. For today in the city of David has been born for you a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You'll find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger.
Suddenly, many angels appeared, and they filled the sky, and they were praising God.
Thank you.
And so the shepherds were excited and went to Bethlehem to see the baby that they heard about.
Did they find Jesus?
They did find Jesus. They found him just as the angels told them they would. They were so excited about meeting Jesus that they told anyone they saw about the baby. They left singing and praising God because this baby was a special gift. have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. And because God is such a holy God, sin really doesn't have a place in his kingdom. We as sinners can't be with God, but God wants us to be close to him and love him. So something had to be done. Someone had to take care of the sin in our lives so we can have a relationship with God.
What happened? For God to love the world, that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. We all have made so many mistakes, it doesn't matter how many good things we do. We are always sinners.
And that's where Jesus comes in. Before he could die on the cross for our sins, he had to live on the earth for a little while. So he did. God gifted us Jesus, his very own Son.
Is that why Jesus was born in the manger?
Yes. Jesus is the most important gift ever, and now we call it Christmas.
We give gifts at Christmas because God gave to us first. We give gifts to our loved ones because we remember what God gave to us.
I'm glad you did well in soccer and got on honor roll, Rose, but I don't think Mom and Dad are going to give you more for Christmas because you did those things.
I can understand that now.
And Billy, Mom and Dad still love you even though you got sent to the principal's office.
I can too. It's pretty cool that God meant his Son for everyone, even though we don't deserve it.
And what a Merry Christmas that is!
Merry Christmas!